Be Blessed by the Divine. The Story of My Life by Sri Vethathiri Maharishi. Chapter 28, Visit to U.S.A. This chapter and the next two are being added to the book in April 1982, on the eve of my ninth visit to the United States of America. The genesis of these trips abroad is interesting indeed. Way back in 1972, Mr. Gullermo, an American who had received training in yoga from me at New Delhi, invited me to the States. He offered to do everything for my stay and services there. I felt like accepting the invitation and made all necessary arrangements for my journey, the first ever planned beyond the borders of India. At this stage, Mr. Gullermo pleaded that he had to go to Singapore on business, and since he would be tied down there for a few months, my trip would have to be postponed. At the New Delhi branch of our center, the responsibility of imparting training in Sky was entrusted to Mr. B.D. Sharma, who was the younger brother of Mr. M.L. Sharma, employed in U.S.A. I wrote to Mr. M.L. Sharma about Mr. Gullermo's suggestion, the preparations I had made for the trip, and about the postponement. Both Mr. M.L. Sharma and his wife, Mrs. Kanti Sharma, had received training in Sky from me, while they had been here in India. Mr. Sharma wrote back immediately asking me not to postpone the trip, but to come and stay with them while in USA. He also offered to do his best for the propagation of our yoga course in the States. My friends thereupon booked return air passage for me, valid for 4 months. I was at Palam Airport on the 30th June 1972. As I was waiting for the Air India plane, I could visualize the peculiar drama of the universal will that had prepared the blueprint of my travel abroad. It had utilized Mr. Gullermo as an instrument to project the trip. After the preliminary arrangements were made, he dropped out of the picture and other friends entered the stage, as if on cue, and the project proceeded. Filled with wonderment at the ways of the Absolute, I meditated for half an hour in the waiting hall of the airport. I thought of all my disciples and friends who had helped to arrange for the tour, and I blessed that they may be in prosperity. I then extended my thought force to America and blessed the people of that country with a strong will that they may develop in spirituality and serve humanity at large for the cause of peace. I thought over the wonderful functions of the universal consciousness. It is a mystic computer of multiple activities between material and spiritual worlds, microcosm and macrocosm. It is to be imagined as a unique and wonderful phenomenon, having all the records of universal functions with automatic receiving and transmitting nature of forces and data from one to all and from all to one. This is a divine natural computer manifested by the evolutionary process of Almighty. As a part of its function, all the aspirations, experiences, and imaginations of the persons who lived all along the ages are imprinted as ever permanent record. All the desires and thought forces of the living persons of the whole world also are then and there recorded precisely without any error. Above the individual minds, it is functioning as a collective mind in connection with all persons living in the world. It is giving correct answers to the questions and doubts of the thinkers as intuition, when they attune the working order of their minds appropriately. It reveals the secrets of nature to the philosophers and scientists. It joins the needs and stocks together in time for the satisfaction and comfort of the living beings in the world. I understood that by the same divine consciousness, my tour abroad had been arranged. On my landing in USA, the Sharmas received me with great devotion and joy. The day after my arrival in USA, I read the good news that the Supreme Court had abolished the death sentence in that country. It was a glad news for me because for 15 years, I had been propagating that the capital punishment should be abolished in all countries. It looked as if the United States received me with a development for which I had striven a lot. I had presented a resolution in the Central General Body meeting of the World Community Service Center in the year 1959, requesting all nations of the world to abolish capital punishment, and it was passed unanimously. This resolution was printed and sent to all nations with a forwarding letter through the embassies of the respective nations. Earlier in 1958, I had written articles in Anboli explaining the injustice and cruelty of capital punishment. After some years, several nations, including Britain, abolished the death sentence. Now the United States announced this historical reformation in the judicial field. I had pointed out the deliberate injustice in capital punishment. A particular man is punished with death sentence because he had committed a brutal crime, no doubt. But what was the crime committed by his parents, wives, sons, and daughters who are deprived of their son, husband, and father, respectively? Can any satisfactory relief be given to the stricken family by the society which dispenses social justice? Further, an individual is a member of the society too. There is something wrong with the society which allowed or induced a man to commit a crime by the force of environment. It is a second crime of the society to punish the individual only without rectifying its own wrongs. The abolition of capital punishment is a sign of spiritual development in the world. This kind of spiritual awakening will definitely lead men of wisdom in all nations of the world to put an end to war which tortures and kills lakhs of people who have not committed any crime. Such deep thinking will lead the nations to unite themselves under one world government, to eradicate war permanently in the world and settle all disputes among the nations through an international court of justice. Story of My Life by Sri Vethathiri Maharishi will continue. Visit simplifiedkundaliniyoga.com. Awaken your kundalini by attending our Sky Yoga Workshop. Be blessed by the Divine.